Hello and welcome everyone. This is Veronika Klausova, Cisco NetSec Technical Marketing Engineer. In this demo, we are going to demonstrate on how to transition from user agent to ISE-PIC solution. In the first configuration step, we are going to integrate Identity Services Engine Passive Identity Connector, ISE-PIC, with Active Directory Windows Management Instrumentation ADWMI provider. This example uses Cisco recommended ISE-PIC deployment in high availability. Deployment consists of two virtual machines where one node is primary and other secondary. ISE-PIC uses Windows Management Instrumentation WMI to collect information about user sessions from Active Directory. In order for ISE-PIC to be able successfully communicate with Active Directory, we need to provide the join name, which is the local name of AD to the ISE-PIC, and then Active Directory domain to which we would like to join. This domain needs to be resolvable by domain name server that is configured on ISE-PIC. In this example, we are going to use domain administrator account in order to be able to configure WMI. Upon joining to the domain, we need to add and configure passive identity. So we navigate to passive ID tab, then click on Add Domain Controllers DCs and select all available DCs where you would like to configure WMI. Then fill in Active Directory credentials in order to configure WMI. For validation purposes, hit test button to make sure the communication over WMI with AD is successful. In the second configuration step, we are going to prepare the certificates on FMC side that will be used for communication over PX3 protocol towards ISE-PIC. In this demo, we are going to use signed certificate by certificate authority. Therefore, we need to obtain a root CA certificate from administrator of our CA third party or directly from the CA server if it is under our control. The CA root certificate needs to be imported to the FMC trusted CA store. This can be done by navigating in FMC under Objects, PKI, Trusted CA, and click on Add Trusted CA, where we need to provide the name of the certificate authority and import its certificate and save this object. Next, we need to add internal FMC certificate to internal certificate store on FMC. FMC does not offer CSR or certificate signing request UI option. Therefore, we are going to leverage OpenSSL tool to create FMC private key and CSR request. This can be accomplished through FMC CLI or any other Linux-based CLI that has tool OpenSSL installed. So in the first command, we have generated the private key, and in the next OpenSSL command, we are issuing CSR request, where we need to provide details such as country code, the state, city, organization name, organizational unit, common name, which represent our fully qualified hostname for FMC. Optionally provide email address, and then display the content of the CSR signing certificate signing request. That will be imported to the certificate authority server, and upon which it will be signed. The generated CSR needs to be signed by our CA server with PX3 certificate template. that has enabled client and server authentication extensions. The signed FMC certificate can be now imported to FMC along with its private key that we generated by using OpenSSL. This is accomplished under Objects PKI Internal Certs Configuration section. Now we have completed second configuration step. In the third configuration step, we are going to prepare certificates on ISE-PIC site that will be used for PXGrid connection towards FMC. Since we are using the signed certificates, we also need to import into the ISE-PIC trusted store the root CA certificate. However, as you can see presented on the screen in the trusted certificate store of the ISE-PIC, the root CA certificate is already present. And this is because this has been done previously, because the admin, the access to the web interface of the ISE-PIC is also using signed certificates for which the root CA has been already required. So we don't need to repeat this step. Now, the next, we need to generate ISE-PIC certificate signing request for PXGrid communication. So we are going to dedicate certificate just for PXGrid communication between ISE-PIC and FMC. Since we have our ISE-PIC in high availability deployment, so we have two nodes, we are going to leverage wildcard certificate. It is important that within the CSR request, within the certificate signing request, we specify in subject alternative name in SAN the both fully qualified domain names of the primary and secondary ISE-PIC nodes. And with this, we can generate the CSR and export it to local PC and subsequently upload to the certificate authority and get it signed. The CSR request needs to be also signed by specific PXGrid template that has enabled client and server extension, authentication extension. The certificate that is signed will be imported back to ISE-PIC and bind with the generated CSR request. We need to make sure that the option for usage with PXGrid is enabled. After this, when we navigate to the system certificates, we can validate that each node in our high availability have specific certificate just for PXGrid purposes. And with this, we have completed third configuration step. We will notice that under the subscribers, the PXGrid status is still unavailable because we haven't configured the PXGrid integration yet, and we are just about to do so. At this point, we did all the necessary pre-configuration for the smooth transition from the user agent to the ISE-PIC with the minimalistic impact to the network. So as you can see, the user agent is currently configured and being leveraged. There is new warning presented under integration section, and also as a health warning in 5.6.6 release in order to notify the administrators that the user agent is going end of life and should be replaced by ISE-PIC for passive identity solution or ICE when the TrustSec solution is also required. We did all the prerequisites, so now in order to make the transition from user agent to ISE-PIC, we just need to provide the ISE-PIC hostname for both nodes in case of high availability, the sign root CA for the PXGrid and MMT server CA section, and then FMC sign certificate. Additionally, the session directory topic is only option that is required to be enabled, since this is the option through which the FMC is getting passive user identities. The SXP topics is used for TrustSec when we are integrating with ISE. At this point on ISE-PIC, you see under the subscriber that the PXGrid status is active and the FMC became online. So basically the FMC can successfully communicate now with ISE-PIC and vice versa. On the ISE-PIC, in case the automatic certificate-based connection is not enabled, then the session that is established from FMC to ISE-PIC needs to be manually approved under the subscribers configuration section of ISE-PIC. And with this in mind, all of the new user logons will be parsed by the ISE-PIC from the Active Directory and then streamlined to the FMC, and FMC then push it down to the managed devices. So all of the existing configuration for user identities should remain working as it was before with user agent. After the smooth transition from user agent to ISE-PIC, we can now run through some validation in order to confirm that the previous configuration that worked with user agent remains working with ISE-PIC as well. So we have two clients for this demonstration, client 1 and client 2. And as you can see, the ISE-PIC is learning about those new identities when they log in back to the Active Directory PC. And when we go to FMC under Active Sessions, Analysis Users Active Session, we see them successfully streamlined from ISE-PIC to the FMC as well. So let's review quickly the configuration. So our access control policy, which has been there before and was working with user agent, and it instructed client 1 from Active Directory is blocked, going towards the web server, and any other Active Directory PC going to the same web server is allowed. So now we are going to generate the traffic from the client 1 PC from the Active Directory, and per our configure rule, the traffic should be blocked. And indeed, as the response page is saying, the traffic was blocked. Whereas when we go to the client 2, the traffic should be allowed, and we get the content of the outside web server, and the connection has been allowed as per the previously configured access control rules with our identities. The same behavior we can actually validate from the connection events to make sure that connection events are actually reporting the user identities and the action has been done accordingly. So for the client 1, the traffic has been blocked, and for client 2, the traffic should have been allowed, so there should be allow action for this user. And indeed, as per our validation, all remains working as before. This concludes actually our demo, so thank you very much for your attention.